All right, we're back for part two. So on day one, typically when I'm working with kids on choral counting by 1/4, I'll record their ideas and I'll make a model. Now, I'm gonna come back to this chart the second day because I can really get a lot of information from kids about what they know about fractions and maybe some things we need to work on. So for example, Cynthia might have noticed that as we go down the chart, we're increasing by 4/4. So then I would ask the entire class, stop and think. What number or fraction do you predict will go here based on what Cynthia said? Now, I do not listen to kids when they yell out answers. I just ignore them because I really want everyone to have the time they need to process it. And so while it might come quick to some, this is a whole class activity. So I'm gonna give them some think time. So typically they'll realize that it's 12/4, or excuse me, 13/4.
Yeah.
And then we'll verify and make sure 9/4, 10/4, 11/4, 12/4, 13/4. So you can ask the kids to predict what might come next. Now you can do this on day one if you have enough time, but if you don't, pause it and come back to it on a second day. So one of the things that kids tend to notice on day one is that 4/4 is 1 whole, 8/4 is 2 wholes, 12/4 is 3 wholes. So a question I'll ask the kids is, if we have whole numbers here, do we have any halves? And then I'll be quiet and give them some think time, right? So some kids will say, well, 4/4 is 1 whole, so 2/4 must be 1/2. And so I'll write that there. And if Chris recognized it, I'll write Chris's name below. Other kids might say, well, 6/4 is 1 whole and 1/2. So I'll say, is that true? Let's look at our chart. Here we have 4/4 is 1 whole. And then if we get to 6/4, we have 1 whole and 1/2, right? So some kids will see it with numbers. Some kids will see it with the model. We want to have both. And if 6/4 is 1 1/2, then 10/4 must be 2 1/2. So just by using one choral counting chart, we can tap into these ideas of equivalent fractions in a way that's, it's easy for kids, to be honest. They can see it again in the numbers or in the patterns. And so they're doing this equivalent fraction work, which typically tends to be very challenging and cause a lot of frustration, in a way that's easier for them and makes sense. And I'm like, I mean, we really want kids to learn, and yes, we want to challenge them, but we don't want to frustrate them. So equivalent fractions, we can make matching between halves and fourths. And so I just want to annotate all that thinking and dive in. So equivalent fractions, great thing to look at through the lens of choral counting. Now, other things I might do on day two is pose some equations based off of the chart. So I might ask the kids, to use the chart to solve that equation. I might also do something like 2 is equal to what fraction? And again, they can use the chart. I might do some unknown, right? Plus 1/4 is equal to 6/4. And again, they can answer all of this just by using the chart or the models. And then let's see, we've got some addition here. We've got some equivalent fractions. We can even do some subtraction. We could do something like 12/4 minus what? Ooh, this could be a challenging one. Will get us to 2 wholes. So you can really play with these numbers and these fractions here, help students learn how to count by fractions, make connections to models, look at equivalent fractions, and then help them make connections to equations in a way that's fun, it's engaging, it's a lot easier, and it helps kids to really feel successful with math and feel like, you know, math is doable, I can do this. And they can. So I'm so glad you tuned in to Teaching One More. I'm gonna have some more videos on choral counting, but try this out in your classroom. I would love to hear your feedback. How does choral counting by 1/4 go for you over the course of 2 to 3 days?